This week on Maker Update, robots that glide, robots that walk, a bouncy bike, and a blade that's bewitched. Hey everyone, I'm Donald Bell, and this is Maker Update, our weekly show covering the latest DIY projects and tips from makers like you. I hope you're doing well. We've got another great show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. In his workshop, Jay from Engineezy has this long workbench across one wall with an impressive amount of storage at eye level. It's an enviable situation, but it comes at a price. A table this big is a magnet for clutter and works in progress, and with this many bins, it can be a real chore just to locate and retrieve a part. So why not build a robot to handle it all? One that can not only pull out and put back the bins you need, but also tidy up your workbench. In this case, the robot is a long overhead gantry system that glides back and forth and uses a servo arm at the end to grab onto things. And while that may sound relatively logical and straightforward, the reality of making it is like a nesting doll of different and increasingly complicated challenges, with each one resting on the foundation of the other. For example, the whole thing starts by mounting linear rails on the wall for the whole thing to travel on. It's no easy task, requiring large sheets of CNC cut MDF and a precision machine system of rails and bearings. And if the rails aren't level and consistent, the accuracy of everything down the line gets thrown off. Still, that's a relatively intuitive problem to solve. It's big, it's structural, and it's easy to measure. But how do you move the robot up and down? How do you get it to reach a bin? How much weight can it support? Where does it put a bin once it has it? And how do you even tell the robot what to do? It seems that every milestone leads to a smaller, more complicated challenge, but who better for a challenge like this than Jay? It's a fun video and a great project, and you can find a link to it down in the description. Now for some news. Last week, the Disney Imagineering team released a 30-minute video compiling some of their latest work. This is the same team that delivered the BDX duckling droid, which is still the envy of anyone into robotics and animatronics. This time, the star of the show is a new robot based on the Olaf snowman character from the movie Frozen. From a mechanical perspective, the underlying robot seems to use a similar walking system as the BDX droid, though the legs and hips are higher, raising the center of gravity and making the balance more challenging. You also have articulating arms here, which the BDX does not, and a moving mouth, moving eyes, and eyebrows. It's a real leap forward. Though the Olaf section only makes up about 5 minutes of the video, I recommend watching the whole thing. There's a ton of other impressive robotic stuff, including this ball-balancing version of the Herbie robot from the Fantastic Four. Another interesting innovation I came across this week came to me through this article on the IEEE Spectrum website. It's an article on a type of device called an event sensor. You can think of it like a camera sensor, but instead of capturing data in an entire image, it only looks at elements that are changing. Not only does this make the data more efficient for certain applications, such as movement detection, but you can also capture movement in greater resolution because you're not constrained by frame rate. It also makes the captured data easier to interpret by computer vision systems because all of the irrelevant data, all the stuff that doesn't change, is eliminated from the equation. We're already seeing this technology trickle out to some AI starter kits. It will be interesting to see how the technology matures and trickles out to the rest of us. More projects. With over 3.6 million views already in less than a week, chances are you've probably already seen the magnet suspension bike video from Colin Furze. But I can't not mention it, especially if there's a chance you missed it. It's such an entertaining and weird project. The gist of it is you get to watch Colin Furze create a bike suspension using only the repelling force of magnets. It's messy, it's funny, it's sciencey without feeling academic. Definitely worth a watch. I was also excited to see that after a 5-month break, Svetlana and Benny from KamuiCosplay are back with a new video. This time, they're making Xal'atath, Blade of the Black Empire from World of Warcraft. Aside from offering a window into all the different steps and techniques that go into creating a prop like this in EVA foam, you also get to see how they added a microcontroller and adjustable LEDs to light up both the center and the writing along the blade. Plus, you get a look at some great painting and weathering techniques. It's a fun and inspiring video, and Svetlana's energy is infectious as always. Now for some tips and tools. On his YouTube channel, Sergey from Mishin Machine demonstrates how he created this unique, clever three-ring cycloidal drive. The design uses 3D printed parts along with a handful of ball bearings, steel pins, press fit bearings, and a brushless motor. Aside from looking super cool, the gearbox offers a 20-to-1 gear ratio in a compact package, ideal for robotics. Maybe make a few for your DIY Olaf project. Best of all, Sergey shares the Onshape CAD file for the design so that you can play with it too. Tis the season for holiday gift guides, and if you're shopping for a fellow maker in your life, there are a couple I've come across that are easy to recommend. First up, the team from Adam Savage's Tested channel are each publishing their own gift guide videos. As of this recording, we've got videos up from Adam, Kate, Sean, and Norm, and they're all great in their own right. I'll link to the playlist collecting them all. There's also a useful one from Essential Craftsman. This one includes a bunch of inexpensive stocking stuffer items. It leans a little more traditional garage workshop, but there's a lot of practical items here that any creative maker type would be happy to receive. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, check out one of the latest videos from DigiKey's product discovery channel. This is a liquid detection evaluation kit from Microchip. It includes sensors for both capacitive and conductive liquid detection, along with a potentiometer to set the sensitivity threshold. The whole kit connects up over USB-C and runs around $32. You can learn more using the link in the description. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. A big thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.